Our oil and gas series ended last week, and I hope you enjoyed the series and learned something. We will return to the subject of oil and gas early next year to probe it a bit further and see whether Ghana is really on track to producing oil by the last quarter of 2010. But between now and then, I thought we should return to some of our earlier interviews. And I've been through my notes, and a couple stood out and struck me as very interesting. We begin today with an interview that we did a couple of years ago with Patrick Awuah, the founder and the president of Ashesi University. Patrick said some very interesting things about education and about education in Ghana in particular. He spoke about what it means to be an educated person. He said a parrot can learn some English words, but it doesn't mean it understands English. He said there's too much emphasis on passing exams and too many lecture halls where the students simply take notes from the lecture. He says affluent people should pay for their own education and subsidize the poor. And he offered some great ideas. If they were good ideas, what have we done with them? Mr. Patrick Awuah, thank you for coming.
Thank you, David. I'm glad to be here.
Patrick, what does it mean to be an educated person?
Big question. An educated person, in my view, is somebody who has a very broad vision of his or her life, of society, and who is striving to live a more excellent life.
Where do skills fit into that then? Isn't that part of education?
People preparing themselves to live a more excellent life or more excellent lives.
So it could be.
So the idea of excellence is very broad. I mean, what is an excellent life? I mean, is it just having a good life? Is it just reading for the sake of reading?
It's impacting society.
It's impacting society.
Yes. But do people here do that? I mean, let's come to Ghana. Let's spend some time talking about it. Because you are an educationist. I want to know, and I want your honest views. I mean, it would seem that we are churning out people that really, many of them are not marketable. This country's challenges are not being addressed by its educated people. Am I right or wrong? What is your view on that?
You're right. I think that we have a long way to go to fix our educational system. And it's one of the reasons I quit Microsoft to come back to Ghana to get involved in education is because I saw some gaps. Mm. And there are many of them. There are many, many gaps. We'll start from just technical competence is something that you seem to care a lot about. Mm. You know, I had colleagues who stayed for their education in Ghana and who studied computer science, computer engineering. Mm. And in their letters to me when I was back in the US, you know, they were describing an education in computer science where they were not doing any programming or doing hardly any programming. So they were just studying a lot of theory and they were writing code on paper.
No practice.
No practice. And now clearly anybody who does that is not really a computer scientist. I mean, he's not really, or she's not really, a programmer, a software developer. You actually have to have hands-on practical experience in order to be competent in your field.
Is that something that we find across board quite a bit here with education? I mean, you've spoken about computer science, that's one area, but I dare say that applies in many other areas.
It's everywhere. You know, I spoke with somebody who's he's actually a professor at Legon. He was telling me about his nephew in JSS studying carpentry. And the exam, you know, they had to define what a hammer is and draw a hammer. And this kid actually didn't do carpentry, didn't do any hands-on carpentry. They just read.
They read about carpentry and the tools of carpentry.
And nails and hammers.
But they never used the hammer
before.
Never
used it.
So, why? Yes. Why? Why did they do that? Why do you think that is the case? There has to be a reason. I mean, either they just don't have the resources. Because you see, that's a different thing. They don't have the resources, fine. But if they don't even realize that that is important, then we have a problem. Do you think this is because of the resources not being there? Or do you think it's really a function of, you know, attitude? They think, look, once the guys can pass this exam, our job is done.
You know, David, you're asking me a question that's very difficult for me to answer.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I ask myself the same question.
But it must
be
the
example I gave you about hammers and nails. Mm. I mean, this is not about resources. Mm. A hammer is not an expensive tool.
I wouldn't imagine.
Right? Mm. So there's something else, and we need to figure it out. But I think I think that we just need to really take a very hard look at what we're doing in education. We have to take a very hard look at what the outcomes are that we expect in an educational system. If somebody, you know, responsible for education is sitting back in his or her office and saying, well, you know, people who've studied carpentry need to know what a hammer is and what a piece of wood is and what nails are, then they're going to get it wrong. But if they say that someone who studies carpentry must be able to be an excellent craftsman, must be able to design beautiful works of art, so that the carpentry is not even just about function, it's function, but it's also aesthetics. It's about improving, you know, humanity in a deeper way. Then the way they execute that educational program will be different. And so it's, you know, you use the word attitude, I would say vision, I think.
And leadership.
Leadership. It comes to what is the vision of where we want to be.
We have to decide what kind of people we want to have.
Right.
What we intend to do with them, and so on and so forth.
Yes. That's correct.
Tell me, let's just stay here very quickly a little. Do you think we should be training more middle-level people, you know, artisans, more people with more practical skills as a nation, I mean, for the challenge of development? Or should we be producing university graduates, or both, for that matter? I mean, my question really is, tertiary education has been a battle. The resources must go to primary and so, not tertiary. What do you think?
We need a broad spectrum. I mean, an educational system should look like a pyramid, so that you have a very large base. The foundation is primary education, really, in kindergarten, actually. You need to make sure that everybody is literate.
And it's expensive.
And it's expensive if you want to do it right, but it's also very expensive if you don't do it right.
That's the issue.
You know, a lot of the conversation here, a lot of people say the sentiment you just described, well, education is expensive,